Have you ever wondered about the product Smite and Banish? Smite is a pesticide and Banish is a fungicide. Will they work? In this video, we're going to get into it. You're here with Mark Batwell at PerfectGardens.com. Just want to say thank you so much to Aaron Ray, one of our newest members. He ended up asking for a review on Smite and Banish. And I actually really appreciate he asked this. I think I might have found a pesticide, a fungicide I could be willing to try out if I'm in a crunch, have a problem, and if I'm going to be concerned about possible testing protocols on my food and vegetables. I can definitely tell my end product will most likely pass all testing with this product. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Okay, so what is Smite? So Smite is comprised of rosemary oil, cottonseed oil, peppermint oil, and geranium oil. Rosemary, peppermint, and geranium are all repellents. Cottonseed oil works in suffocating the bugs. Just a couple weeks ago, I did a product review on green cleaner, and they use soybeans. So if I had to use an oil as a way of suffocating the bugs, and I had to pick between cottonseed oil or soybean oil, I would definitely pick the cottonseed oil. Real quick, what are all these acids and additional things underneath, like the peppermint? It has the methadone, and you see all these right here. All these are other organic compounds. You can also call them amino acids. Amino acids are comprised of carbons, hydrogens, nitrogens, sulfurs, and oxygens. All of these things you see right here, all these acids are what rosemary is comprised of, right? Same thing here and same thing here. And that's all they are. They're just small amino acid chains. And how they work is they work to repel the bugs. The basic thought process around this is that if your tomato plants are weak, or any plants in general, it releases a pheromone that actually will go and attract bugs. In some level, I can trust this because if you think about the exudates and the fungi and them retrieving the food, why can't another pheromone be released by the plant to say, hey, come eat me, I am weak, I'm ready to start dying. So how the rosemary and the peppermint geranium oil kind of work is they deter the bugs or kind of annoy them from being on your plant because that pheromone acts as a way of telling them that the plant is healthy. You can use a Smite for spider mites, aphids, thrips, and leafhoppers. One thing I was actually really impressed by this company was they have a phone number that is on the Amazon link, and it's actually all over their website, that if you call it, you can actually get a hold of someone. When I made this phone call to this gentleman, it was 7:30 on Saturday, and he picked up the phone twice. I actually called him once, and then I called him twice. First, I called him once, and then I actually ended up calling him back a second time, asking additional questions, and the person was super professional. I definitely have to give him 5 stars on the customer service side of things. What makes Smite different than other essential oil products on the market? And this is what he was telling me. Obviously, he has to send me more information. He said he would give me a little bit more insight into how they use nanotechnology to make their essential oils more water soluble versus oil based. You've heard me talk about this all the time, that oils have different boiling points, and when you put another oil on a plant, they will fuse together. And the only way to separate them is through a distillation process. Some plants do produce similar compounds, aka amino acids, aka essential oils. That's why when I'm putting on an aroma like rosemary or peppermint, I actually don't mind using these types of repellents on my plants because their end compounds are very similar. Once again, the compounds being amino acids. Once again, amino acids are comprised of organic compounds. Organic compounds are comprised of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, and oxygen. All of these amino acids are comprised of carbons, hydrogens, and oxygens. I'm going to start using these types of bigger word terminologies on the channel because I want you guys to become familiar. I think this industry uses a lot of these terminologies to confuse people so that they can overcharge you on pricing. You've seen me do price comparisons, and I'm actually going to do a price comparison on this product to see if I think the prices they're charging you actually do at some level justify the cost. Because obviously these businesses do have employees, manufacturing costs, they have to order large bulk inventory, so that upfront cost is normally a big deal as well, and then you have to sit and turn your product, obviously. Before I get into that, let's talk about Banish real quick. Banish is comprised of geranium oil, peppermint oil, and isopropyl alcohol. In past videos, I've talked about how isopropyl alcohol processes in your body as acetone. While researching this video, I actually learned that acetone is something that your body naturally produces. The only time you do produce acetone, though, is when you're overweight and have excess fat. Excess fat does lead to a very acidic environment, which leads to candida. So once again, even though the body does produce acetone on its own, it's normally producing because of an unhealthy environment. If I was going to talk to the company again, I'd probably recommend them purchasing ethanol alcohol because it's a much healthier end product and a cleaner overall product, especially if you're going to be spraying your plants, because isopropyl alcohol does have some small residue. Once again, the reason why I would use both of these products, even if it does have isopropyl alcohol, is because of their nanotechnology, which I don't know anything about yet. Although when you do look at their concentrations, it definitely does go much further than most other essential oil products on the market, which is something that I brought up to the surface as something to consider on other products I have made reviews on. Once again, the Smite is for bugs like spider mites, aphids, thrips, and leafhoppers. Banish is a fungicide for things like powdery mildew. The mixing ratios for Smite are 1 ounce per gallon. Obviously, if you buy the 2 ounce, it's a little expensive, but roughly as you go up in quantity, it does get a little more inexpensive. The Banish goes much further. The 2 ounce will mix up 15 gallons. So definitely, if you're having a powdery mildew product, the Banish is probably going to be much more cost effective. If you're going to buy something, just make sure it works at the end of the day. When I started doing the cost analysis on the product, all I normally do is go over and I check out the raw materials. In some level, is it going to justify the cost of what they're charging you? Like right here, they're charging you $15 per 1 ounce for 1 gallon. Depending upon the size of your grow, that can get fairly expensive. So I'm always wondering, does the manufacturing cost justify the retail cost? So when you buy rosemary at 444 pounds, it's going to cost you $10,000. So that's right there kind of expensive. When you buy $400 of the peppermint right here, it's going to cost you $11,500. And the geranium is going to cost you $42,000 for the 400 pound. Even the cottonseed oil, which is actually fairly expensive, that's going to be $47 on eBay. So when I review their products and I review how much their cost of inputs are, I am taking a look at their overall thought process around how they're creating their products. I would definitely have to give Smite and Banish a thumbs up. Yeah, they can get rid of the isopropyl alcohol, although kind of learning that your body does produce acetone. I have to lighten up my past rigid opinion that acetone's bad for you, especially if your body produces it. Although I do have to consider that it only produces it when you have excess fat and are somewhat unhealthy. So if I was going to make one recommendation, switch it over to ethyl alcohol. Besides that, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Love to know your feedback on these two products if you've ever used them, because overall, they seem to be decent products. Have a great grow, everyone. Monsanto's is owned by Bayer, which is a pharmaceutical company. Okay, calm down, Mark. It doesn't matter that a multinational conglomerate company that has been known for thousands and thousands of lawsuits and the releasing of some of the worst man-made pesticides, if not the worst, this world has ever seen. Although I really have to reserve my emotions whenever I'm doing a product review to the best of my ability.